Welcome to the first lecture in the module 2 in the subject Hydrology and Water Resources. So, in today's lecture, we will study about precipitation. What is precipitation? What are the modes of precipitation? And what are the types of precipitation? Okay. So, let's start. Hydrology is basically about water cycle. Okay, how water circulates inside the atmosphere around the earth surface, how it circulates. So one of the important phenomena in the circulation of water is precipitation. So what is precipitation? Precipitation means that in any form, water from the atmosphere comes to the earth surface. Okay, then all such forms collectively are called precipitation. Okay, all these forms are nothing but precipitation. What can be example of it? Example of precipitation is, can be rainfall, can be snowfall, can be drizzle, can be sprinkle, can be thunderstorm. So there can be many such example for precipitation. Okay, so what is basically precipitation? It is all the forms or any form of water by which water from the atmosphere reaches to the earth surface. Okay, so that is basically your precipitation. So let's start here. What are the forms of precipitation? So in how many forms water can reach to the earth surface? So one of the most familiar example is rainfall. Okay, barish bhi kya hai, ek type ka precipitation. So the first is rainfall. So the thing is, how you are going to identify that what is rainfall or what is snowfall or what is other type? So you have to identify, so you have to give them some definition. Okay, when the precipitation follows this particular definition, then we will say that this is now rainfall. Okay, it is precipitation, but its subcategory is rainfall. So when there will be precipitation following a specific definition, then we will say now this is called rainfall. So what is that definition? So the definition is, when the size of water droplet is larger than 0.5 mm. okay, jab बूंद की साइज 0.5 mm से क्या होगी, बड़ी होगी, तब ही हम उसे कहेंगे रेनफॉल. इफ द साइज ऑफ ड्रॉपलेट इज लेसर देन द 0.5 mm, वी विल नॉट से इट एज रेनफॉल. वी विल कॉल इट समथिंग एल्स. ओके, व्हाट एल्स वी विल स्टडी लेटर. सो टू बी कॉल्ड रेनफॉल, द साइज ऑफ ड्रॉपलेट शुड बी ग्रेटर देन 0.5 mm. Similarly, another boundation is, the maximum size should not be greater than 6 mm. The size of droplet should not be greater than 6 mm. And what is the third note is given here, that any drop larger in size than this tends to break into smaller pieces. What does this means? That for the size of raindrop or water droplet can be lesser than 0.5 mm, but whenever it will try to be in larger size than 6 mm, it will automatically break. Okay, because of gravity. Okay, so usually there won't be any droplet size in the air which is greater than 6 mm, because during its fall, it will break into pieces. So that is what the note is saying. Okay. So let us say now you are in a place and there is rainfall is going on, and I want to say that okay, aaj bahut barish hui or aaj medium barish hui. So how will you classify that, when I should call that this is heavy rainfall, or when should I say that this is the medium rainfall? Okay, so this thing has to be decided. So how are you going to decide? There can be many categories or many definitions. You can fit your definition. So right now we are following classification based on intensity. So if intensity of rainfall is such that it is lesser than 2.5 mm per hour. Okay? कहने का मतलब है अगर एक घंटे में सिर्फ 2.5 mm या उससे कम रेनफॉल होती है तब हम बोलेंगे क्या है वो लाइट रेनफॉल, इट इज लाइट रेनफॉल. सिमिलरली इफ दिस रेनफॉल इंटेंसिटी इज 2.5 mm टू 7.5 mm पर आवर, व्हेन द इंटेंसिटी इज बिटवीन दिस रेंज वी विल से दैट राइट नाउ द rainfall is of moderate category. Okay, it is moderate rainfall. Similarly, if the intensity is greater than 7.5, then we will call it as a heavy rainfall. Okay, so this is a classification how scientifically you can classify the rainfall. Okay, it is not like that if rainfall is there, you are watching, simply sitting, and you say, okay, rainfall seems very high, it should be heavy rainfall. No, you should classify, you should try to fit that rainfall in the definition. If that rainfall satisfies the definition, then only you can say it that it is a heavy rainfall or light rainfall. Okay, this is the engineer's approach. Okay, how you can classify that. Okay, so we have classified rainfall. Then, so basically the first form in which precipitation can occur is rainfall. Okay, what is the other form of precipitation? So there is another thing is called drizzle. So what is drizzle? So when water droplet size is lesser than 0.5 mm and intensity is lesser than 1 mm per hour. If this is the mathematics or values of the precipitation, then we should call it as drizzle and not rainfall. Even though water is falling from the atmosphere, still we will not say that it is rainfall. We will say this is drizzle. Okay, so I have also pinned a picture in which there is water is coming from the atmosphere and falling on the earth's surface, but this is not rainfall, this is your drizzle, because it fits or satisfies this particular definition. Okay, this is how we should classify everything. Okay, what else can be the form of precipitation? So another thing can be snow or snowfall. So there's nothing much to describe about snowfall. When the water converts into snow, so and then in form of snow itself, it comes to earth's surface through atmosphere, then it will be called snow or snowfall. So I have also pointed here that when snow is new, the density is around 0.06 to 0.15 grams per centimeter cube. And usually when you have to take any value, average value, you usually take around 0.1 gram per centimeter cube. So these are the factual values. You may not remember them, but in background you should know that this is certain way how rainfall or snowfall behaves. Okay, if you want to analyze something in a more mathematical way or more fundamental way, then you should remember this way. In India, usually snowfall is very, very less. Only in Himalayan region there is snowfall. In any other part there is almost negligible kind of snowfall is there. Okay, so moving ahead. What can be another form of precipitation? So another form is called glaze. So what is glaze? So glaze is when snow and or water falls from the atmosphere and it enters in a region and suddenly the temperature goes below 0 degrees Celsius. So in such case when water will form, it will suddenly freeze because of lower value of temperature, or it will get because of latent heat of fusion, it will convert into the ice form. So here I have seen a picture also, so in which the rain drop came and it got frozen covering a grass. So this kind of precipitation is called drizzle. Okay, so we categorize it as a different mode of precipitation. Okay. Then another is sleet. So what is sleet? Sleet is another kind of another mode of precipitation, in which the basic difference is that the ice is of transparent nature. Okay, so all other things are almost same as compared to your glaze. Okay, most of the things are same, but one of the important feature of the sleet is that transparent nature of the ice. Okay, then another is hail. In hail, the size of raindrop is usually much higher. Okay, so I have not noted down here value, but the size is usually very, very high, and it even can harm you when you stay in the hail. Okay, when this size may hit you, and then you may feel a jerk in your body, and you may get hurt because of hail. So these are basically the types of precipitation, how precipitation happens, okay, all over the earth. But if you see particularly India, so in India the most predominant type of precipitation is rainfall. In India the hail is not there, or sometimes it is in very negligible amount. Very negligible snowfall. Okay, most of the time there is rainfall only. Okay. So we have now classified the modes of precipitation. Okay, so let's move ahead. What more things? Okay, so now how precipitation happens. Okay, so here I have shown a diagram in which this reddish part is your earth surface. So because of heating of the sun, the earth becomes warmer. So the earth surface is usually warmer, and as you go up the temperature decreases. So when water is present on the earth's surface, because this is a higher temperature, this is a lower temperature, there is a difference of the temperature. Thus, there is a difference of energy, and every system want to be in the stable condition. So, for being stable, what the energy will do? It will go in the lower energy state. So because of this concept, the water at the earth's surface gets evaporated and starts moving upward. Why upward? Because the temperature is lower at the upward and energy is in the lower state at the in the upward direction. So because of this, air rises upwards, and when it rises upward, it slowly gets accumulated and forms the cloud system. Okay, so when this cloud system goes up and up and up and up, and after a certain point, so why basically it stops there at certain height, the clouds stop rising. Why? Because this rising is happening because of density difference. आपने बचपन में ये 12th में पढ़ा होगा कि आप पानी के ऊपर ऑयल डालते हैं तो वो ऑयल ऊपर आ जाता है, पानी नीचे रह जाता है, क्योंकि डेंसिटी पानी की ज्यादा होती है और आपकी ऑयल की क्या होती है, कम होती है, तो वो ऊपर आ जाता है. लाइट डेंसिटी वाला जो भी लिक्विड होता है या फ्लूइड होता है वो ऊपर होता है. सिमिलरली आप इमेजिन करेंगे कि जब इस तरीके से ये जो क्लाउड्स अपवर्ड मूव करते जाएंगे और जहां पे ये क्लाउड की डेंसिटी और एयर की डेंसिटी क्या होगी, बराबर हो जाएगी, वहीं पे जाके क्लाउड क्या कर जाएंगे, रुक जाएंगे और एक पर्टिकुलर हाइट पे क्या होंगे, क्लाउड्स ही क्लाउड होंगे. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ क्लाउड स्टॉप्स देयर एट दिस हाइट बिकॉज ऑफ कंडेंसेशन, देन वाटर अगेन फॉल्स डाउन ऑन द अर्थ सर्फेस, सो दस द प्रेसिपिटेशन हैपेंस. ओके, सो This is the basic concept of precipitation. Now, there can be various other ways also in which precipitation can happen. So, let's see them. The first is frontal precipitation or front precipitation. So, what is this kind of precipitation? Let us say that if this is some air mass, and there is another air mass, okay, this is second air mass, so it is moving like this, okay. So when two air mass is moving like this, let us say the temperature is higher for this one, and temperature is lower for this air mass. So when these two air mass will collide, because of higher temperature, it will go above this colder air mass. Okay, and because going above, it will create a push to this hotter air mass, and it will get lifted. And because of lifting, there will be a process of condensation. And because of that condensation, there will be precipitation or rainfall. So, when rainfall happens, because of this reason, the rainfall or the precipitation is called frontal precipitation or front precipitation. Okay. So, another type of precipitation is cyclone precipitation. So what is cyclone precipitation? It is slightly tricky, but right now you can remember it as there is a creation of low pressure area in the ocean. So because of low pressure area and the combined effect of Coriolis forces, the air mass starts moving. Okay, and because of this moving, the combined air and moist air and water start moving toward the land surface. So in this way, this moist air causes rainfall or precipitation on the land mass. So this kind of precipitation is called cyclone. So it is important to note down that cyclone occurs only in the oceans or sea or water bodies. There is nothing like a cyclone on the land. Okay, they start from ocean, they somehow enters in the land, and then they got disappeared. They loses all the water on the land surface. So that is the basic phenomena how a cyclone happens. Okay, so let's move ahead. then what is the anti-cyclones? So in cyclone, the basic difference is in cyclone, in the center there is a low pressure area, whereas in the anti-cyclone it is a high pressure area, and other phenomena is almost same, but almost same, and the so many things are different also. Like in anti-cyclone, the outer region is usually calmer and there's no much destruction on the outer surface, whereas in the internal surface there is a high pressure, so which may cause destruction also. Then another is convective precipitation. So what is convective precipitation? That when the air mass, when the air mass or the packet of air which is warmer than the particular area or surrounding, so due to because of some intense heating in a particular region or in a local region, due to localized heating, okay, the air at that region, it gets heated and it rises up, and because of its rising, okay, since the heating is in a particular region only or in a particular area only, whereas the other surrounding area is colder than that particular region, so there is a difference of temperature. Because of that difference in the temperature, the raised air got cooled, and there is a phenomena of precipitation. So the convective precipitation is all about localized heating. जब एक ही जगह heat बहुत ज़्यादा हो रही है, तब उस तरह का जो precipitation होता है, वो usually convective type precipitation होता है. Okay? Then now in the last we have orographic precipitation. So the first note that we should see here, that in India the major mode of precipitation is nothing but orographic rainfall. So what is orographic rainfall? So let us say this is some mountain. Okay, this is some mountain, and some clouds are coming like in this direction. So when they hit this mountain, okay, so because of hitting this mountain, they moves in the vertical upward direction, and because of upward direction, the temperature is lower in upward direction, and thus the condensation process happens. So the precipitation happens in this side. Okay, so this side of the mountains is called windward side, and the other side is called leeward side. जिस साइड से बादल आते हैं वो क्या कहलाता है आपका? विंडवर्ड साइड. और दूसरा वाला साइड क्या कहलाता है आपका? लीवर्ड साइड. सो चूंकि बादल इस साइड से आ रहे हैं, यहाँ पे हिट करते हैं, हिट करने की वजह से उनका एक कंपोनेंट वर्टिकल डायरेक्शन में होता है और वो अपवर्ड मूव करने लगते हैं. अपवर्ड मूव करने से कंडेंसेशन होता है और बारिश होती है. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इन दिस रीजन और दिस साइड, दिस विंडवर्ड साइड, देयर इज ऑलवेज हैवी अमाउंट ऑफ रेनफॉल. But on the other side of mountain, there is very less rainfall. Okay, so you can check here a note that in India also there are some regions like Bundelkhand which are located in leeward side of mountain. So they are located in the leeward side of mountains. Due to which there is always a scarcity of rainfall in those area. So this is how basically rainfall happens. So this is all about today's lecture. We will continue in the next section. थैंक यू।